Welcome back. So starting out the week, the first thing to do was to have the guide coat sprayed on these door frames. So Jeff stepped up here and got underway with spraying those. And that'll allow me to do the sanding on those and see all the high spots and low spots and all the places that need fill. And there was quite a few areas there where there was little pinholes because of the raw carbon fiber starting out, not having any fill in those areas. So anyway, that's going to keep me busy for a few days, sanding that and getting it ready for the next round of primer. And you may remember last week I had created these aileron rods after getting those tubes back from powder coat, and I created the little inserts there out of aluminum and threaded those and put them in. But I needed to actually drill some holes here in order to be able to put some bolts through there to lock those aluminum inserts in place so they can't slide out. They were a pretty snug fit, but there's just no way that you're just going to let them sit there. They need to have some hardware running through there. So I put it up on the machine there, and it's an easy way to get a nice sort of stable platform there for drilling a hole through not only the 4130 steel but also the aluminum rod. So I had to do either end of four of those, so eight holes altogether. So I got those done. And Devin started out Monday morning laying up the first of these door panel skins. So these are the ones for the inside cabin there behind the front door, sort of in the back seats there. And he's just starting out on the right one. And each of those got two layers of medium weight and carbon fiber. So here you can see he's just putting down the first layer right now. And it didn't take him too long. And here you can see he's already putting over the perf film there to allow the part to release once the bag comes off. And I moved over to creating some more of these pushrods there. These are the ones for the elevator controls in the floor plane. So I'm actually just drilling out the ends of some half inch aluminum rod there. Because we don't have the lathe, and it was too cold to go up to Brits to go and use a lathe. So I figured I'd just try it with the machine, and it worked out okay. And you can see Devin's gone and got that first one all bagged there and under vacuum. So that just needs to set up now, and it can be released and trimmed, which should be later in the week. And having drilled those rods out using the machine, the next thing to do is to tap the ends. And I'm using a right hand tap on one end and a left hand tap on the other end. And it turns out I actually didn't have the left hand tap. I thought we did have one, but maybe it got broken or lost or something like that. So I was able to do all the right hand ones, and then I had to wait until Tuesday for the left ones to show up. And here's Devin working on the second one now, just putting the first layer of carbon down there and getting it all wet out. So that'll be both of those trims. And then what's left there for the trim panels there is side sort of kick panels in the front, but they'll be coming later on. And here you can see Devin now is just putting that perf film on that one again, and just getting all the wrinkles out there using a dry brush. So he's definitely had enough practice of doing this type of technique, so he's got it down now and was able to do everything all on his own. So it's pretty impressive. So I'm probably going to see about doing some panels just for the overhead on the roof in some areas there on the left and right, but we'll see that later on. And here I'm putting the rod ends in the end of those aluminum rods that I drilled and tapped before, getting those all ready. There's a finished product, at least half finished. I still need to tap the other ends with the left hand tap, and then put the hardware in for those. As you can see, they're drilled but just not tapped. And these are all going to sit in between each of these different actuators there for the elevator. And after getting quite a lot done on those push rods there for the elevator, I decided it was time to man up and start doing some sanding. So the first thing I did was fill some of the pinholes there on the side there were those front areas for the strake tanks, because those were raw carbon before and they really needed to get some fill. And same the one on the other side, and then after that, just onto some sanding. And by the end of the day, Devin had the other one there all bagged down as well, so we got both of those done for the day, which was actually pretty good. And then he was on to doing a couple of other little things and some cleanup before the day was shot, but it's good to have those panels done. So as I said, front panels to go still, and then probably some roof ones. And Tuesday, Devin was out sick and Jeff was taking a vacation day, so I was pretty much in the shop all on my own for the day. So quite a bit of sanding underway there, as you can see. And I did that for the most half, or the first half of the day, and got this frame pretty much done. Decided to actually switch over to dry sanding. I actually did wet sanding on the other side, but dry sanding actually seemed to be working out better. So I got most of this one done, and I still need to do some more on that one tomorrow, and then won't be too far away from being able to go into the next round of primer. By around lunchtime, this is where I'd gotten to, so got the frame pretty much sanded all the way around. It actually came out pretty good, considering how much work was done on this door to, you know, made up the two different flanges there and all the other different fills and stuff. It actually doesn't require that much fill over there, but anyway, more to do still. And Jeff had come in briefly in the morning and just taken the bag off of both of these door panels, and they came out nicely. So they're still not fully cured yet, because it's been a little bit cold in the shop with the temperatures outside around hovering around freezing there overnight, so they need another day to cure up before we can release them, but overall they came out well. And so after sanding all morning, I decided to spend the afternoon doing some more work on the hardware. So here I'm putting those bolts in through those aileron rods, because I had ordered those from Spruce and they arrived in the morning. So those are just AN3s, and that'll keep those rod ends there sort of locked into place on the tubes. So those are now, the aileron rods are done, the main ones, and also I still have to do the shorter ones now that actuate the actual aileron themselves. But I'll be doing those probably later in the week. I have the materials to do those. So getting close to having all the hardware done now for the wings at least. And here I'm just working on pressing these little bushings there, those bronze bushings, into the actuator there for the elevator. And this is the one, or the actuator, that sort of lives on the front center section of the spar, on the forward spar. So, and the holes that I had in there were 3/8 inch diameter, and that's what the bushings are, but they just, even though I reamed the holes, those bushings just were really snug and just wouldn't push in by hand. So anyway, just using the vise kind of like a press, I just pressed them into place, one on either side. So that's sorted now, so I can put the hardware through there. And this is where it lives, on the front of the spar here, and obviously the spar is still sitting in the fixture there, so it's upside down. But that hard point was put in there a while back in the front of that spar sort of closeout, and it was already tapped there for a quarter inch bolt. So all I had to do was clear that out a little bit and bolt that in place. So, and this actuator basically transfers the motion there coming out of the cabin from the stick, from pulling back and forth on the stick, and turns it into rod motion left and right, which actuates the elevators. And as you can see here, just sort of putting the rod in place there, that's kind of how it sort of sits. And we still have to drill the holes out here in the ribs there for the where the rods go through, and then obviously put in the bell cranks there that they'll connect to. But each of the rods is sort of connected in tandem there, and each one sort of has its own rod there that connects to the elevator, and those are the short rods here. And I actually got those done there, or at least half of those done, before the end of the day. So kind of a busy day for me in the shop today, pretty much on my own the whole day, except for Jeff just briefly in the morning. Anyway, so that's our update for the first half of this week, and tune in again on Saturday and see what we get up to.